Maybe some Broadway Lullabies on our way, plus preaching the good word on the small screen. Here to talk playing a charismatic televangelist, Fox's new show, Filthy Rich. It's Aaron Lazar. Aaron, good morning to you.
Good morning, Sam. How you doing?
Really, really good. Nice to have you here. Tate Taylor behind this. Really interesting show. You opposite Kim Cattrall. A televangelist, but is it safe to say he's a little shady as well?
Yeah, he's definitely a little bit shady. He's got his own agenda.
All right, and with that in mind, we've got a really good clip between the two of you. I think these soap operas that, you know, remind me of Dallas or Knott's Landing are fun and sort of bigger than life. Is this a fun thing to do because there's so much to kind of chew into?
Yeah, man, we had a blast. We shot in New Orleans, and the cast was just, everybody got along. We had such an amazing time. And now, with everything going on, my God, I hope everybody's having as much fun watching it as we had making it.
Well, I tell you what, people are enjoying new material now, and I think this is an interesting thing to lift the veil off of. Let's show this clip, and then my sense is you're kind of trying to take over a little bit from what Kim Cattrall controlled.
You have no idea what danger you've put us in.
We can protect you if I have that tape.
Well, it's hidden someplace. You'd have to be crazy to look.
I had a feeling you were bluffing.
This room here, it's by invitation, Paul. There is a tag. Isn't there, Ginger?
I have a parade to get to.
No tape, no witnesses. You think you're the queen of New Orleans, Margaret? It's Mardi Gras. You don't even have a float.
Boom! What's on the tape, Aaron?
Well, this episode premiered last night, so the tape is the governor doing some very scandalous things with Ginger's company.
Ooh!
It's a sex tape, basically. Oh. Yeah.
Well, there you got to have one of. If you're doing a story based in New Orleans, you got to have one of those. Let's talk about being creative during quarantine. Talk to me about Broadway Lullabies.
Oh, man, thanks for asking. Yeah, my kids were feeling all the anxiety, early pandemic, and I've always been singing them to sleep with, I've done a bunch of shows on Broadway before moving to L.A., and so I would sing them to sleep with my favorite Broadway songs. I'd reimagine them as lullabies, and it worked. Like, it calmed them down. It calmed me down. We all were, like, conking out.
Oh my gosh. He is frozen just at the point where we're going to ask him to sing one, which would make it incumbent upon me.
But do you want to do it instead?
I won't do that. Pardon me?
Do you want to do it
instead? If only I could. That's a shame that I'm not capable. You can catch new episodes of Filthy Rich Monday nights on Fox. Broadway Lullabies, which does sound really good, drops for the general public in November. Back to the two of you, and thank you for one half of each of your Dodger donuts.
It makes a whole. Thanks, Sam.